Welcome, here I've got Honor 9X Pro and I'm gonna show you the top tricks of its camera. So at first we have to tap on the camera button to open it, and for now we are in the standard photo mode. Let's see what we've got here. Let me start with this settings bar. Here by moving to the left or right we can change the modes of this camera. We have the aperture mode, night, portrait, standard photo, standard video, and by going to the right to more we get access to the other ones like pro, slow motion, panoramic, light painting, HDR, time lapse, moving picture and stickers. So this is a lot, I don't have much time to speak about all of these modes now. I suggest you to making experiments with that and just have a good fun. You can also go to the right corner to this I letter button to read some short information about all of these modes, and you can also learn from this. Now let me show you one of my favorites, the moving picture. By just one tap we get access to it, and here when we take a photo we get two in one, the picture and the short clip. Let me show you how it works by taking a photo. Let me get some space now to the camera, and this is my object. So let's go back to this view. And to see the picture, let's move to the left corner to this button. When we tap here, we get quick access to the gallery, and this is the photo. To play the short clip, we have to tap on this button, the second from the right, and this is how it looks like. Let's play it again. And now let's go back to the camera. We are again in moving picture mode. Let's just tap here on this X letter to go back to standard photo mode. And let me stay here. Now let's tap anywhere at the screen, like that. As you can see, we get access to this ring with this small sun icon from the right or left. And the ring is the focusing. We can pick the focusing area anywhere at our picture we need. And when we tap on this sun a little bit longer, we get access to extra slider with exposure compensation, so we can manage the light of picture. As you can see, by going up we can make our photo more bright, by going down we can make it more dark, and when we tap anywhere we go back to the auto settings with that. Now let's have a look at these buttons from the right. Here we can manage the lenses of this camera. Now we are on wide lens, we have also the standard lens, and then we can get closer to the subject. This is connected with zoom, so let me show you now how to use zoom. We can do it by using two fingers like that and get closer to the subject and also go back. We have this slider which appears here, and by using it we can also use zoom. I think this way is more precisely, and we can also tap on these buttons a little bit longer to get access to this slider, so we have many ways to open it. And now let's stay here on the standard lens and let's have a look at this settings bar here. Let me start with this button, the second from the left, with the flash. Here we can pick the auto flash, so the camera should recognize when it's needed, when it's too dark, when we want to take a picture. We can of course turn it off, and we can turn it on every time we take a picture also. And we have access here to flash always on, so the torch. Now let me keep this turned off and let's move to this button. By just one tap we can turn on auto intelligent feature, auto intelligent photography, so now the camera should recognize. For example, here it recognizes we have the text, so the scene we have when we take a photo, and should give us the best possible settings. Now let's turn this off and let's move to this button. When we tap here we get access to the filters, and we can make the photo just more beautiful before we take it. We have this slider, and this is how to use this. So we can pick whatever we need here. Now let's stay unknown. Let's turn this off by another tap, and let's tap to the right corner button here. Now we can open the advanced camera settings. As you can see, we have general and capture settings categories. Let me show you a few of them. Let's start with resolution option. When we tap here, we can manage the aspect ratio of the picture connected with the quality. We have quality in megapixels. Also here we have access to the best possible quality of this camera, 48 megapixels in two options. And now let's focus on aspect ratio from the left, because this is the difference we can see by our eyes in the camera preview. We are in 4:3 ratio. Let's pick 1 and 1 now. And let's go back to the camera. Now the background has changed to the square one, so this is how it looks like. Another tab to the right corner to the resolution, and we can pick also the full screen. And in the camera preview now we can see the full camera frame. So this is how it works. And of course another tab here to the resolution then, and we can pick again 4:3, so to remind you, this is how it looks like. And let's stay on the settings from the right corner. Now let's move to the location tag option. Here we can add the location information to our photos in the details about it. By using this button we can turn it off and turn it on. And also the important information here is that to make it work correctly, when we want to save the actual location of our picture, we have to be connected with the internet, for example with the Wi-Fi or the mobile data, and we have to turn on the location of this device. So remember about these two parameters to make it work: location and the internet. Now let me keep turned on all of these settings. Let's go back to the camera to take a picture. To see it, let's move again to the left corner here to the gallery. And now here we have the photo. To check its location, we have to tap here to this I letter button from the right corner, and here we have the details with the location and the full address. So greetings from Krakow, Poland. And now let's go back to the camera, to the settings in the right corner, and move to add watermark option. By using this button we can turn on the camera watermark and turn it off. Now let me keep this turned on. Let's go back to the camera to take another picture. To see it, let's move again to the left here, and here we have the photo with the Honor watermark in the left corner at the bottom. Let's get closer to it. And this is how the watermark looks like: Honor 9X Pro triple camera. Let's go back now to the camera app and to the right corner. Of course here we can turn off watermark by using this button when we don't need it. So for now when we take another picture it should not be visible. And let's move to the capture settings category now. At the first place here we have assistive grid option. So by using this button we can turn on some camera grid lines and turn them off as we need. Let me keep this turned on. And in the preview now we can see these lines. This is useful when we want to use the rule of third, for example in photography or making experiments with composition. Also remember that these lines are not visible at the real picture, so when I take a photo and again when I go to the left to the gallery we can't see them. So the grid lines here are only to help us taking better photos. Of course when we don't need them we can tap to the right corner once again and use this button, so the grid lines now have gone in the preview. And let's stay here in the capture settings category. Another useful feature here is the mute. Here we can turn off the camera sounds by using this button or turn them on again. And now let's have a look at the timer. When we tap here we can change the delay of taking picture. We can pick 2, 5 or 10 seconds of delay. Let me pick 2 seconds to show you how it works. And let's go back to the camera. And now let me take another picture. Here we have the countdown and the photo was taken with 2 seconds of delay. So let's go again to the right corner settings. Let's pick the timer and turn it off and move to the audio control option. When we tap here we get access to this button so we can turn on the voice control. And now when we take a picture we can do it without touching the screen by saying for example cheese to take photos, or we can pick speak loudly to take photos. Let me stay on say cheese now. And let's go back to the camera. Let me try to use this now by saying cheese. And the photo was taken, so this is how it works. And it's really cool. Now let's go back to the right corner. Let's stay down. Also here we have capture smiles option. So by using this button from the right, of course, we can turn it on and off. And it capture smiles when sees the people that are smiling. You have to discover it by yourself because as you can see I don't have a model and I can't show you how this option works, but I think this is really useful. And after managing all of the settings, sometimes we want to go back to the auto settings. We can do it by using the last one option here, restore defaults. When we tap here we can reset settings to the default values, and now we can start using the camera app from the beginning. And that's all. Thanks for watching, subscribe our channel and leave the thumbs up.
Thank you.